wake up.
What? Where am I?
The Citadel. It's my home.
Who are you?
I am the Catalyst.
I thought the Citadel was the Catalyst.
No, the Citadel is part of me.
I need to stop the Reapers. Do you know how I can do that?
Perhaps. I control the Reapers. They are my solution.
Solution? To what?
Chaos. The created will always rebel against their creators. But we found a way to stop that from happening. A way to restore order.
By wiping out organic life?
No. We harvest advanced civilizations, leaving the younger ones alone. Just as we left your people alive the last time we were here.
But you killed the rest.
We helped them ascend, so they can make way for new life, storing the old life in Reaper form.
I think we'd rather keep our own form.
No, you can't. Without us to stop it, synthetics would destroy all organics. We've created the cycle so that never happens. That's the solution.
The defining characteristic of organic life is that we think for ourselves. Make our own choices. You take that away, and we might as well be machines, just like you.
You have choice, more than you know. The fact that you are standing here, the first organic ever, proves it. But it also proves my solution won't work anymore.
So now what?
We find a new solution.
Why are you telling me this? Why help me?
You have altered the variables.
What do you mean?
The Crucible changed me, created new possibilities. But I can't make them happen. If there is to be a new solution, you must act. It is now in your power to destroy us. But be warned, others will be destroyed as well. The Crucible will not discriminate. All synthetics will be targeted. Even you are partly synthetic.
What exactly will happen?
Your Crucible device appears to be largely intact. However, the effects of the blast will not be constrained to the Reapers. Technology you rely on will be affected. But those who survive should have little difficulty repairing the damage. There will still be losses, but no more than what has already been lost.
I made it this far. We'll destroy you without setting it off.
Impossible. You are vastly outnumbered. You have sacrificed many of your resources just to reach this point. If you do not use the Crucible, the Reapers will not be stopped, and the cycle will continue.
I don't believe you.
Your belief is not required.
There has to be another way.
There is. You could instead use the energy of the Crucible to seize control of the Reapers.
So, the elusive man was right after all.
Yes, but he could never have taken control, because we already controlled him.
But I can.
You will die. You will control us, but you will lose everything you have.
How can I control the Reapers if I'm dead?
Your corporeal form will be dissolved, but your thoughts and even your memories will continue. Your connection to your kind will be lost, though you will remain aware of their existence.
I didn't fight this war so I could give up everything I have.
And I do not look forward to being replaced by you, but I would be forced to accept it.
Not if I refuse to do it.
There is another solution. Synthesis.
And that is?
Add your energy to the crucibles. The chain reaction will combine all synthetic and organic life into a new framework. A new DNA.
Explain how my energy can be added to the crucible.
There is little time left, but I will try. Your organic energy, the essence of who and what you are, will be broken down and then dispersed.
To do what, exactly?
The energy of the crucible, released in this way, will alter the matrix of all organic life in the galaxy. Organics seek perfection through technology. Synthetics seek perfection through understanding. Organics will be perfected by integrating fully with synthetic technology. Synthetics, in turn, will finally have full understanding of organics. It is the ideal solution. Now that we know it is possible, it is inevitable we will reach synthesis.
Why couldn't you do it sooner?
Tried a similar solution in the past, but it has always failed.
Why?
Because the organics were not ready. It is not something that can be forced. You are ready, and you may choose it.
You're asking me to change everything. Everyone. I can't make that decision. I won't.
Why not? Synthetics are already part of you. Can you imagine your life without them?
That's beside the point.
Your time is at an end. You must decide.
No. I'm gonna end this war on my terms.
Then you will die knowing that you failed to save everything you fought for.
I fight for freedom. Mine and everyone's. I fight for the right to choose our own fate. And if I die, I'll die knowing that I did everything I could to stop you. And I'll die free.
So be it. Whoa, what? What the fuck just happened?
The cycle continues.
I don't know what I did, but that was terrifying. That was never an option before. No. What did I do? Oh shit. I don't know what I did. I'm so scared.
Holy shit. I slapped the fuck out of my mic.
If you're hearing this, then there is still hope.
I think I found the fourth ending.
Hope that you can avoid the same mistakes we made. We fought the Reapers. But we failed to stop them. We did everything we could. We built the Crucible, but it didn't work. We fought as a united galaxy, but it wasn't enough. I only hope the information in this capsule is enough to help you before it's too late. My name is Dr. Liara Tassoni. Herein lies the recounting of our war with the Reapers.
I fucked up. Oh, shit. Ah, damn it. Okay. Well, that was interesting. I only just recently heard about this fourth ending. That was not the ending I wanted, though. I wanted to control the Reapers because... That is actually a really hard decision. I think that was a little bit more decent than the options we were presented with beforehand. Like, beforehand, we didn't even know how our allies, like, got off the ground and were on the Normandy before the DLC of the actual ending, I suppose. And how you're gonna came out. And now that we have it, we see that, oh, your allies left on the Normandy because one of them got injured and you didn't want them to die. You knew you were gonna fucking die, so just send them away. Sounds like a plan. Love that plan. Mass Effect 3 is a great game. If you guys haven't played it, I definitely recommend it. But play Mass Effect 2 first. It'll set up a lot of the storyline for you, and it'll allow you to experience some unknown variables, as in like the just the actual combat and shooting. Because when Mass Effect 1, it goes from using L2R2 to Mass Effect 2 that uses L1R1 for shooting, which is really annoying to me. I actually figured it out later on in Mass Effect 2 that you can change it. Still really stupid. But, you know, it's definitely a good game all in all. But I definitely wish I would have known about the, that fourth ending a while ago, because that was definitely different.
Did that all really happen?
We'll never know exactly what it was like, but yes, the archives tell the true story of those who came before us. They fought a terrible war, so we wouldn't have to.
If you look really closely, that's in Sorry.
Yes, without everything they accomplished, without the information they passed down, we too would be threatened.
What else do we know about the Shepherd?
Just what we have in the archives. But I've only told you a few of the stories.
Can you tell me another one, please?
It's getting late, but okay. One more story.
As I was saying, Mass Effect is definitely one of the more thrilling trilogies, especially with the fact that you definitely get to choose how you play. Like, I went all Renegade through all three games. Yes, I did do a few good options. I did I do comfort people every now and then. It's just the more you grow with the characters, the more you're gonna want to be like, yeah, I'm gonna definitely take Paragon points just so I can be a comforting person when you're crying. Yes, I'm gonna take those Paragon points just so I can show you that I care about you. And it allows you to actually care a little bit more. Unlike in other games where it's like, oh, okay, here's your main character. He's kind of silent. You can choose his talking options. Here's your ally, and they just fuck off and kill shit. There's no chance to ever talk to them and be like, yeah, I love you. You're cool. I wish I could do things with you. Okay, hold on. I fucked up. But for now, we're actually going to head back to... That cutscene, please tell me it's not saving. That's not what I want. That's not what I want. No. Motherfucker, I hate this system. Stupid PS3. Thank you so much. Speaking of stupid PS3s. Okay, looks like I have to go all the way through it again. I'll cut it, don't worry. But anyways, as we just kind of run through this, Mass Effect 3 is definitely one of the more heartbreaking games because, like I said, at a couple moments I did start like to tear up and I wanted to cry so bad. I desperately tried not to. When Morin died, I was so depressed. I felt the tears coming out of my eyes, man. It sucked. Whenever I play this game, I always tend to cry. because like I said, I developed so much with these other characters. Morden I love because he's just so wacky, so crazy, and you don't get a lot of that in other games. And if you do, I haven't played them, so screw you. It really did sadden me when I'm just sitting there kind of thinking to myself, no, I want Morden to live. There has to be another way. Let Edie hack the hell out of the system. Just make sure Morden lives. Meeting Javik and then having to do all this stuff with them, getting to learn a lot more about the races that his people uplifted. It's definitely one of the more very very game changing things that they got going on here. As where as where in every other game I've ever played, it's just kind of a different setup where you learn everything through like text logs and shit. That's partially one of my favorite things about the Mass Effect series. Is yeah, you can still learn stuff through text logs, and you can still learn stuff through like what's going on around the worlds. However, when you add in the character presence, like Javik, someone who's seen all these races and helped uplift them, like the Salarians did with the Krogan, you can definitely tell that the same scenarios have been going on for like all of eternity. It's this game just inspires so much out of life, and I really was looking forward to doing this just before Mass Effect Andromeda came out, because again, this is one of my favorite games because of all the things that happen around the galaxy. You fight the Reapers, and I would believe it if Mass Effect 1 was just supposed to be a one-off game, and then everybody liked it and people were like, dude, this is the greatest game ever, and BioWare was like, here, have Mass Effect 2, and then they brought out another game, and it's like, okay, so we were just planning to make the sequel. Here, have Mass Effect 3, which, out of all the reviews I heard before I started YouTube, the Mass Effect 3 game was awful just because of the ending. The game was perfect otherwise. Like, people had nothing but nice comments to say about the combat, the narratives, the people you met. When they came out with Javik, people had nothing but nice comments to say about that. Everything about this game was perfect. Until you hit the ending. Which, when I first played, I really saw no problem with it. I thought, okay, this was a good ending. I liked it. However, then when they released the DLC for the actual ending, or even better endings, I suppose. I forgot what they actually called it. Everything became a little bit more clear, and then when I played it again with the real endings, I was like, wow, this is actually something more likable, not something that was just thrown together last minute, which I really hope they aren't doing with Mass Effect Andromeda. This game is on hype. A lot of people want this. People want Mass Effect to come back, and because they're putting it into a new galaxy, we're expecting something new, not something same old, same old. We're not expecting to see the same exact bases. We're not expecting to see Rex. We're not expecting to see Garrus. I expect to see Krogan, Asari, Salarians, maybe Geth and Quarians every now and then. I don't know. Out of what I've seen, it's just Krogan, Asari, and Turians. And humans, obviously. It's gotta be in everything. We're pompous little shits. But I don't want to see anybody from the past. I want to hear maybe references like Commander Shepard, Savior of the Galaxy. Something like that. Something like that would be nice. Maybe even incorporating... Oh, wait, you can't because it's on a different system. It would be nice if you could incorporate like the Mass Effect 3 character you created. You up here too? Everything that they did all the scenarios that they went through, everything that happened, if you could incorporate that into the actual Mass Effect Andromeda gameplay somehow, that would be perfect. Like, you look into the what is it called? Not the journal, the codex, I believe. So the codex or the journal.
Just gotta keep moving.
And you read about it, and it's like the Reaper War, the Reaper Invasion, and then it lists details of what Commander Shepard did, how he did it, what actions happened. Maybe not in complete and utter detail.
Makes sense.
But in enough detail where it's like, yes, that was perfect. Highly doubt they'll actually do that, but
they round them up on
besides,
Earth,
I'm like then send the months behind giving out any fucking input for in game. But it's definitely something interesting to have Mass Effect 3 go on like this, and then to actually kill off characters and to make probably a good majority of the players feel some sort of emotion here. It's definitely something different. But honestly, like I said, I haven't played too many games that have RPG elements. I play a lot of first-person shooters and a lot of things that don't really have too good of a story element. It's literally just blow through everything, kill everything in your path, and don't stop until everything and everyone is dead. Not no real story to it, just shit's happening, shit's exploding, shoot shit, and get the hell out alive. That's about all there is. Like I was saying before, the indoctrination theory that I was reading about, it's actually really interesting. The fact that Admiral Anderson and, what was his name? The Lucid Man are all in Shepard's head makes it all kind of like connect. Like, as we see, there's two options here. Two options that obviously the main character wants. To destroy or to possibly control. The control would be the Lucid Man, and to destroy would be Admiral Anderson. And supposedly, out of what I've read, is Anderson died within the first push. Like, as soon as they got out and started running, Anderson got murked by fucking Harbinger. He got instantly lasered.
Anderson.
He's dead. Anderson's long dead. And the Elusive Man, well, he's just being a little shit and using Anderson against our will. And I don't blame him. However, like, this indoctrination theory just goes beyond my mind. I don't really understand it. All that I know is that I've read stuff, I've seen stuff, and I completely agree that maybe Shepard is indoctrinated. Yes, they're controlling you. Can I please just skip this? I've heard it already.
I don't think so.
I usually play this game, I usually go for synthesis or destroy. I've never actually tried to control the Reapers, because that's what they want. No, I'm kidding. But anyways, we're gonna go and attempt to control the Reapers, because I've never actually done that. Or I might have done it once, I don't remember. But we're gonna go and control the Reapers. I know what synthesis is. That would probably be my favorite out of all the options. I know what destroy does. Destroy just kills everything, and I get really sad about Legion. And I'd rather not get sad about Legion. Legion's a cool guy. Is that my pistol? I'm gonna shoot the ground on my way up. Shoot the ground. Shepard, follow the bullets. Oh, now I'm just shooting at nothing. Oh well. Follow the bullets, Shepard. We're gonna take this fight into our own hands. Oh my god, I can't believe it. This is a first. This is a first out of all the times I've played Mass Effect 3. This is a first. I'm right here. I can't save. Can I turn back and save? No, too late. I can't. Okay. Oh, damn. I'm not strong enough, no! Anderson's dead. Payne's dead. Richard's smiling. Like a little dickhead. I'm gonna miss Tally. But at least I'm at peace with my death. I don't know, at least I don't have to mourn the loss of Legion.
All fleets, the Crucible is armed. Disengage and head to the rendezvous point. I repeat, disengage and get the hell out of here.
Joker, we have to go.
Damn it.
See, even Joker's gonna cry. Big men cry. Fuck all of you. My guess is Joker tried going through the mass relay before everything went to, or before everything exploded. I mean, the bastard was so close to making it. I don't know where the hell he was headed, but my god, he was so close. I'm still curious about where the hell this is, though. You know, the Catalyst Boy Man thing said, that if I destroyed the Reapers, it wouldn't discriminate. Now, if I control them... Ew! I'm Edie.
Immortal. The man I
yeah, that's not creepy. Holy shit, those eyes.
But only now do I truly understand them. And only now do I comprehend the full potential of his decision. Through his death, I was created. Through my birth, his thoughts are freed. They guide me now. Give me reason. Direction. Just as he gave direction to the ones who followed him. The ones who helped him achieve his purpose. Now, my purpose. To right the wrongs of the past. To provide a voice for those too weak to speak for themselves. The man I was knew that he could only achieve this by becoming something greater. There is power in control. There is wisdom in harnessing the strengths of your enemy. I will restore what the many have fought for. I will lead an army that no one will dare oppose. I will protect, defend. I will destroy those who threaten the future of the many.
I am Commander
Shepard. And throughout it all, I will never forget.
Oh, fuck you. Fuck you, Bioware.
I will remember the ones who fought. So that the many could survive.
Thank you.
and I will keep a watchful eye over the ones who live on. Those who carry the memory of the man I once was. The man who fought to become the one. Who could lead the many.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's Mass Effect 3 on my own terms. Not on the damn Reaper's terms. Destroying all that lives. My god, the three endings are actually sad when you think about it. You're always losing something. You gain nothing from these endings, but you always lose something. You lose yourself. Also, I just came to an awful realization. I pushed a relationship between a robot and a human. My two favorite friends too, might I say. And now I'm the robot.
I think shit just got really fucking weird.
But anyways, with that, ladies and gentlemen,
I'm gonna dry my fucking tears and shower, cold shower.
But as I sign off tonight, let us not forget the gamer code, HFGL, have fun, and good luck. We'll see you guys next time. Mass Effect Andromeda. Remember, 4 days. I'm sorry, 5 days, not 4, 5 days.